So hello and good evening. It is Friday, and Friday means Dax Fridays. For those of you that are new to the channel, Dax Fridays means that we go through a Dax function each Friday. Today's function is going to be kit filters. And this video was actually requested by one of you, Ronald Faltus. I'm not saying your name correctly, I'm sure. And he watched the video last week where we talk about calculating filters, and also watch a video from the SQL BI guys in the SQL Beat session. And I said, Ruth, could you do a kit filters video? And I said, absolutely, that is a great idea. So that's what we're going to see today. Stay tuned, just in a second. So, okay, we're now in Power BI, and again, I really recommend you to watch the video from last week, Dax Fridays week, so you will be able to understand a little bit more what I've created here. But very shortly, we have a very simple table with the employees, departments, and salaries. Okay, we've created a measure that calculates the number of employees by that are terminated and are in lay, and we can see here that the calculate measure is actually overriding the filters that we have applied here. And this is what calculate does. It just, I don't know if you remember from my calculate videos, it says, okay, I can give you any car you want as long as it's black. So this is exactly what calculate is doing. We know that. To avoid that, you can write a filter condition. You can use filter instead. Kip filters. What is this doing and why do we need it? Let's take a look at that. So here we have the explanation from Microsoft about kip filters, and it says it modifies how filters are applied when using calculate or calculate table. So the expression is very easy. The syntax is just kip filters expression. How about we try it in Power BI? I think it's easier than reading what is written in here. Okay, so let's see how these kip filters work. Let's go to this measure, copy it, and create a new measure. And this is the way we're going to write it. We write kip filters. And kip filters. And of course, we give it a new name, field keep filters. So now we have our new measure. We put it in our table and let's see what it says. So as you can see, it has the same effect as filters. It exactly what it said it would do on the Microsoft modifies how filters are applied while evaluating calculate. So this is exactly what kip filters is doing. It's actually returning the filters that you apply in here. So when it's calculating the number of employees, it just looks at terminated and LA, but then it allows you to, use the remaining filters you have on your table, for example. So instead of getting 222, it's actually saying, okay, for deliveries, nothing, 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 and then it's two. Okay, so you're probably going to ask me now, when should we use kip filters and when should we use filter? And according to SQL BI, you should never use filter with a table because it will hurt your performance if you have large models. If you don't have large models, no problem. You can still use them, though it could be a good way to get used to by avoiding it altogether. I think there are so many blog posts that are using filter that I don't know how easy it is to actually take away that habit. But at least if you're watching your video, this video you know now. And if you watch the SQL BI guys video, you know that too already. So don't use filter with a table. Use kip filters, or there's a way to use filters that doesn't require kip filters. So keep watching and I'll show you how. One thing you can do, and they explain everything on the video, go to the link, watch it, let's see, with filter, you can actually add values. And I have a video on values, in case you don't know how that works. So you have values, and then status, and the status that will be passed will be terminated, and then, oh, get away. And then you have values department. And that will give you the same thing without actually sending the entire table to filter. So keep filters is basically a way to do that without having to write those two functions. Okay, it's like selected value that it was so useful when they created it before we have to do if has one value. Mm-mm. Okay, so keep filters is a nice little function, isn't it? I hope you enjoy it. I hope you like it. Try to get out of the habit of filter if you can. I mean, it probably sits in your fingers. It definitely sits in mine. But now we know, right? And have a fantastic weekend. I did a video yesterday, I don't know if you've seen it, where I ask you to be a part of the 10,000 subscribers video. If you haven't seen it, it will pop up to the right. So make sure, it feels so weird to say right and point to the left, but you know, so it will pop up to the right. And send me your videos, send me your hellos. I would love to see it. I've started to get a few and I absolutely love them. It's going to be fantastic. So grab your phone. Say hi, and I will see you again on Monday. Take care. Bye.